Hi guys, today we will look how we can convert this boring cylinder into a nice looking cylinder via a method called UV gradient. Welcome to Shader Beats series, where we will showcase small computer graphics concepts and combine them into a bigger picture. Let's jump right into Shader Graph and look how it's made. First, we have UV node, which will give us a color from gradient based on its value. We fit this into a split node and only take G value, which represents Y axis. Finally, we pass this value to sample gradient node and create gradient node with your favorite colors. You can also add one minus node to make it more intuitive. Now let's switch to scene view, where we have our default cylinder. We will create a material with our shader and apply it onto the cylinder. As you can see, the top and bottom of the cylinder are not colored correctly. This is due to UV maps being wrongly mapped onto a model. To fix that, we need to create a model in Blender with correct UV map. But before you do that, I will quickly explain how UV maps work. UV coordinate system is a normalized system, which means that U and V values are in range from 0 to 1. This is great as we can translate a texture of any size onto a model. Moreover, the UV map tells us where on the model one pixel will be rendered. This is done by placing vertices into a UV coordinate space. Here you can notice that default cylinder has vertices wrongly spread out in UV map. To our luck, Blender has a UV editor which lets us edit the position of vertices on the UV map. This is the exact solution to our problem. We will start by creating a new cylinder and modifying its UV map. We want to achieve that top vertices are on top of UV map and lower vertices are at the bottom of the UV map. This will give them the top edge gradient color and lower edge gradient color respectively. Next step is to stretch out middle area so that flow of gradient will be smooth. By placing them in one straight line, we are sure that both the top and the bottom part will have only one color. And voila! We have our model ready to export. Going back to Unity and replacing our old model with a new model gives us expected results. This is our final product for this shader bit. But before you leave, there is a bonus tip. You can use UV value as an alpha of a model and then adjust alpha clip threshold on the material. By doing this, for example, you can animate flowers or trees growing. This tip is actually inspired by Sebastian's leak video, which I will link in the description below. As a quick example, I will model some curved model in Blender. The important thing to remember while modeling is how you unwrap UVs of your model. You need to be careful that you place vertices in order that you want to animate them. Vertices with lower UV value will be displayed before vertices with higher UV value. By bringing the model back to Unity Editor, we can see how clip thresholds hides and shows part of the model. We can also simulate growing animation on a more complex model. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.